Hey guys, Puneet here from Coach. This is video number 25 of step 1 of the advanced quad series. In today's video, I'm going to be teaching you the 1-6-4-5 progression for the minor key. Just before we get into the lesson, I would like to request you to check out the other lessons of this series as also my other guitar lessons. The links to these are in the description below. Also, if you wish to support me and you think that I'm helping you in your guitar journey, please do check out my original music. Streaming and downloading it really helps me in a very big way in keeping these lessons available for free. So as we said, we'll be doing the 1-6-4-5 progression in the minor key. So in the A minor, the one chord is the A minor 7. For the sixth chord, as we said, we have two options, F major 7 and F sharp half diminished or F sharp minor 7 flat 5. Then for the fourth chord, we have D minor 7. We'll not be using D dominant or D7 in this particular progression. And then the 5th chord is the E7. So and similarly for the key of E minor, the chords will be E minor 7. That is the one chord. The 6th chord we have C major 7 and C sharp half diminished or C sharp minor 7 flat 5. Then the next chord that we have is the A minor 7, which is the 4th chord, and then the B7. Back to the E minor 7. The exercises that we'll be doing now are in the tempo of 85 beats per minute. You can use any tempo of your own on any groove in any strumming pattern, that's perfectly fine. Just make sure that there is clarity in what you're playing and that each note can be heard properly, and the notes that need to be muted in the various chord voicings don't ring out. Also, the various chord voicings that I'll be using in this have been taught before in the previous videos, so if you haven't checked them out and you don't know how to play them, do check it out. I'm also providing tabs in the description below which are to be read from string number 6 through to string number 1. The numbers denote the fret numbers and X means mute. So that's it for this lesson. I hope you've understood everything and that you've been able to follow along. Do practice this really well and try to develop a ear for this progression as well. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask me in the comment section and I'll be very happy to reply. If you've understood everything, do move on to the next video.